I'm Clare Yeo, I'm 28 years old and I'm a meteorologist.
I have been interested in the weather since I was 10 years old. I was living in northern New South Wales. In summertime, you can almost be guaranteed there'll be thunderstorms up around that part of the world and really, really large thunderstorms. So I started my interest from watching the weather. It seems like the most interesting job choice. You have to do maths and physics, and I think you need to be good at science in the first place to really want to go down this career path. I did applied physics at RMIT University in Melbourne, and then I did postgraduate studies with Melbourne University in meteorology. But my degree, my basic degree, was a physics maths major. And then after Melbourne University, I was employed by the Bureau where I undertook a graduate diploma in meteorology, so another year. So all up, I did 5 years in total of tertiary study. At the moment, I'm working in the Melbourne head office, the Bureau of Meteorology. As a forecaster, the first thing I do is come in and analyse a weather map to get an appreciation of what the current situation is. I guess I do the glamorous part of meteorology, where I'm studying severe thunderstorms and bad fire weather days. I guess everyone likes to feel that their job's important, but I personally think that severe weather is the most important because it's the first thing on the news. If something goes wrong, or if there's a severe thunderstorm's gone through a major capital city and people have got hurt, or there's been property damage, or if fires go through, it's always first on the news. A lot of my job also involves doing training to fire agency people in how weather affects their fire operations. And in the summer period, I'll do fire weather forecasting, which basically is forecasts for fire agencies to plan their operations ahead, and also severe thunderstorm forecasting. In terms of severe weather forecasting, there's a lot more detail goes into the forecast itself. You have to take into consideration local effects and the topography in a particular forecast site, and you have to be a lot more accurate with the timing of, say, a wind change. I think everyone encounters weather every day, and most people have a general interest in it. That's why a lot of people pursue the career itself. I enjoy the responsibility that goes with the job. It's nerve-wracking knowing that if I don't make the right decision with the forecast, that it has implications in terms of fire agency personnel may be hurt on the line. But that, in the other sense, is also very exciting. It means I'm very, very focused on what I do, and I put a lot of care into my forecast. You can't sort of get away with being relaxed, I guess, in forecasting. The Bureau has been my first career, and I've been with the Bureau for about 7 years now, and I don't see myself really going anywhere else at this stage, and that's quite typical of many people, because most people really, really wanted to be meteorologists for most of their life as well.